Hi, here's another episode of Hands On. Today we're going to learn how to put xChips together. Okay, so here we have a kit of xChips. It doesn't really matter what kit it is. I'm demonstrating one of the kits we have on the store. And it has 6 xChips. It have a bunch of connectors. So let's just quickly go through them. This is a spacer. It doesn't have any specific function. It's good to have in a circuit because it gives stability and it connects the circuit in a redundant way. So power and signal can go through it, allowing each chip to have at least 2 connections to each other. This is a weather chip, a weather sensor. It have a BME280 chip on it, and it can actually measure temperature, humidity, and pressure. This is a core chip, it's a Wi-Fi chip, they have a Wi-Fi antenna here. It has 4 MB of memory, and this is the one that you in the following episode gonna learn how to program. This is a light sensor, so it have a UVA, UVB light sensor on one side, and an ambient light sensor on the other side. This is a programmer. It also works as a power supply, so it supplies power to the circuit. And you can also use it to debug your circuit if you later on want to program your circuit here. And then we have a little display. It's a little graphical display that allows to see how the different thing looks like when they operate. So here's a bunch of connectors we use to put this thing here together. So as you can see here, when we look at it right now, we can see the name of the chips. So it's important the name of the chips faces the same way. So here's no name on this thing here. There's a nice big logo, but the name of the chip is not there. And the same goes for the other chips. Some of the chips may not have this big logo on. Maybe it's, you can see it slightly underneath here. But for example, this one here, there's no room for the logo, but there's still no name. So make sure the name faces the same way. If it's upside down like that, even though that you might be able to connect it or find a connection point, it will not work. The other thing is that each of the chip can typically connect to 2 other sides. So you can see here, the little marker sits to the right. This little tab sits to the right, here to the left. And you need one that have the to the right and to the left to put together. You can see they have to be facing each other. So these two can sit together like, sorry, let's turn around right. This thing cannot sit together like that. It cannot do it like that, but it can sit together like that and like that. So each side, if it have all 4 sides available, can connect to 2 other sides on the other board. So it doesn't matter if it's like not readable, like this is readable straight in the same direction, this thing is sideways and this is upside down. If you connect it, even though they're not in the same direction, you can connect it, you can still connect it. However, if you put it in the same way around, like all up, then you can almost always connect it straight like that. You just have to make sure of one thing. This one doesn't have a connector here because we have to have room for the antenna. And this one doesn't have a connector space here because we decided to use all the space for the screen. So when we build this thing here, we have to have this one at the top because we can't connect on this thing on that side. And we have to have that on that side. It's not strictly necessary. You can, for example, put it here in the middle, but then you can't put a connector between them. You can still put a connector here and here, which means it will still work, but it will be better for stability and redundancy if you swap those two around and connect it like that. So for the sake of how we talk about this thing here, we say this chip here, this side is facing up and this side is facing down. So when you lie on a table, this is up and this is down. So this is a downside or the bottom side and the top side. And the other sides we call north, east, south, and west. So this one doesn't have a north connector. And this one doesn't have a REST connector. And the REST, maybe this one here, doesn't have a SAUS connector. So that have to face down, okay? So when you wanna assemble it, you kind of like lay it out like however you feel it's great for you. It might be you for some reason have to have it in a certain way. You can have that in the middle, you can have it to the side, you can have this here and that there and that, so you have longer. And of course, what you also can do is you can build one long string instead, like this way here, okay? And you can combine the two. So there's many ways of putting this together. So let's put it together here. So I'm gonna take the display. And by the way, this is glass. This is probably the most vulnerable chip of all the xChips you can find. Don't press the glass here, it might break. Hold on the side of the connectors and of the xChips. And you can hold on the side of all xChips. It's easier that way. So when you have like bigger xChips you have to put together, you can also hold on the connectors between the xChips. That doesn't damage them to hold on top. They're very seldom that you damage the xChips. Neither the way you put them together or the way you touch them. But obviously with all electronics, if you have a lot of anti-static electricity and you discharge them by touching them, then you can ruin the xChips. So I want to put this thing here together with my Wi-Fi chip. So I put it together like that. And then I want to put one here next to it. So I put one here and I put one here. Now, when I have to put the next row in, it's easier to put it in, to put that together first. If I put that one in here, it's difficult to put one in the corner here because I can't connect them at the same time. So I make it like this. I think I'm gonna put this in the middle. So I'm gonna put a connector here, put it together there. Then we put this one here, one more here. And now we're ready to put these two together. So we take the rest of the chips here, sorry, connectors. And we click them together like that. Okay, and then, oops, sorry. Just have to look properly. And then we click it together like this in here. Okay. So now we build our circuit. I have already flashed this thing here. We're gonna learn that in another episode, how to flash it. But just to show you how it works, I'm now just plugged it in and turned it on. And you can see this little light here, like the symbol says, just means the power is on. And up on the display, you can see what's happening. In this case here, it connects to a hotspot, but it allows you to reconfigure it if you do it within the first 2 minutes. This is just how this software is done. You can do your own software any way you want, but this is done this way here. That specific software is available on download if you go to GitHub/xInABoxSamples. So this is the end of this video here. Follow some of the other hands-on videos to see how we get to this point here. Thank you very much.